Greetings everyone, and welcome to my channel. In this video, we are making a basic tutorial on how to use BLAST algorithm in Python for sequence similarity searching. Let's get started. Firstly, we install BioPython. Once BioPython is installed, we need to import the required module for the BLAST analysis. In our case, we need to import NCBI www and NCBI XML from BioBLAST. After performing the BioBLAST, we need to perform the BLAST search. And to perform a BLAST search, you will need a query sequence and a target database. The query sequence can be either a DNA or a protein sequence, and the target database can be a local or online database. In this example, we will use the NCBI's online BLAST service and search for a DNA sequence. Now let's define the query sequence. I will leave this query sequence in the description of the video. And then we have to perform the BLAST search. In this code, we use the qBLAST function to submit the BLAST search. The first argument specifies BLAST program to use the BLAST in this case for nucleotide sequences, and the second argument specifies the target database NT for the NCBI nucleotide database. In step 4, we parse and analyze the results. Once the BLAST search is complete and we need to parse and analyze the results, using the NCBI XML module from BioPython. Let's parse a BLAST results. Now let's access the alignment details. We need to extract information from each alignment and print details such as alignment title, score, alignment length, and the match query and subject sequences. Now let's break down the code. BLAST record alignments. The BLAST record is a parsed BLAST record obtained from the search results. Alignments is an attribute of the BLAST record object that represents a list of alignments found in search results. Each alignment contains information about the sequence match. For alignment in BLAST record alignments, it is a loop that iterates over each alignment in the list of alignments. alignments, high scoring segment pairs, or HSPS, is an attribute of the alignment object that represents a list of high scoring segment pairs. High score segment pairs are segments of the query and subject sequences that align well with each other. For HSP in alignment HSPS, this is a nested loop that iterates over each HSP in the list of HSPs within the current alignment, and then print sequence alignment title. This line prints the title of the alignment, which typically includes information about the matched sequence. Print score HSP.score. This line prints the score of the HSP, which represents the significance of the alignment. Print length HSP.alignLength. This line prints the length of the aligned region between the query and subject sequences. And print query HSP.query. This prints the query sequence within the aligned region. For subject HSP subject, this line prints the subject sequence within the aligned region. And finally, backslash n, this line prints a blank line to separate the details of each alignment. Now let's break down the information that we obtained. Sequence GI25718-5616, GB GQ415693.1, Solanum tupersum clone 8161.C microsatellite sequence. This line, the title or identifier of the subject sequence. In this case, it appears to be a microsatellite sequence from the plant species Solanum tupersum potato. And the score is 61, presents alignment score, which indicates the quality of the alignment between the query and subject sequences. Higher score generally indicates a better alignment. Length is 38. This indicates the length of the alignment, which is 38 base pairs in this case. It represents the number of the positions where the query and subject sequences align. And the query here is G80, CG80, CG80, and so on. The query sequence is displayed here. It represents the sequence used as query in the BLAST search. Subject GATCG and so on. This subject sequence represents the matching portion of the subject sequence found in the database. Overall, the output provides information about the alignment, including sequence titles, alignment score, alignment length, and the actual sequences involved in the alignment. Now, step 5, which is close the result handle. After we finished with the BLAST research, we have to be sure that we closed the result handle to free up the system resources. That's a basic tutorial on how to use BLAST in Python using BioPython. We can customize the code according to our specific needs, such as using different BLAST programs or working with protein sequences. Remember to refer to the BioPython documentation for more detailed information on the various options and functionalities available for BLAST analysis. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If yes, then please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, hit the like button, share the video, and leave your comment under the comment section. Until next time, happy analyzing.